Dear God, sometimes I'm not sure I know who I am. Sometimes it feels like I'm cursed in ways beyond my understanding, ways that trace the path of generations of women before me, women who've held strong under the pressures of motherhood and all other things. I know that you wouldn't forsake me, Lord, but it's starting to feel like maybe I'm not stronger than the battles I'm facing. I'm not like other people. I haven't cried in years despite my trauma. Maybe I'm afraid that if I finally shout, it will be an infinite scream into an earless void. But prayer works. This, for me, will be enough. Amen.
What's taking so long in here, kiddo?
Hey, Mama, was she always there?
Who?
Her, that lady in the tree.
I don't understand. What lady?
She's looking at you. Do you see her yet?
No, sweetie. Maybe Mommy needs her glasses.
But she's right there!
Hey, I hear you. You know what? How about another round of GoFish?
Okay, I'm gonna beat you again.
Oh, only if I let you again.
Angie, hey.
Hey, baby. How's the retreat going at the cabin? Everything okay?
Are you alone? Is Kayla with you?
She's sleeping. What's going on, Cameron?
Nothing. I've just been getting a really strange feeling about this place lately. I don't think the program is working. I'm just ready to come home.
Then come home. We miss you. I know I said take as much time as you need, but this house hasn't been the same without you the past 2 weeks.
But it's not that simple. I was driven out here from Milwaukee to hang out at this cabin in Whitewater as a part of the mental health program, and it's really cold, and there are trees and trees for miles. I just have to stick it out for 2 more days and I get to come back.
Well, that's not so bad.
But there's just one really huge tree out in the woods. It looks like it has a face. And every day it just seems like it's getting closer and closer. And I feel crazy. But when I try to go to sleep at night, I can hear branches twisting and breaking in the dark sometimes. Honestly, I'm just a little scared.
Cameron! Baby, you're You're not moving. Cam? Cam? You've been bringing random sticks and dirt into my house?
No, I didn't go outside.
Please, don't lie to me. Look at this carpet.
I'm not lying. I didn't do this, I promise.
Sweetie, that doesn't make any sense. If you didn't do this, then who did?
It's a lady who paints.
Kayla. Look. I am tired. And I don't want to hear any excuses. We're not going back and forth about this tonight. I want this cleaned up by morning.
But,
please, no back and forth. Lie down. Cam, guess what? Cam will be home in just 2 days. He wants me to tell you good night. And that he loves you. Wrong.
My lights flickered, and I kept hearing a knocking sound on my wall, like this.
Wait. Where'd you put all those sticks?
Nowhere. They just disappeared. I'm scared. Can I please sleep in your bed tonight? Please? Mama, it's hurting him.
Oh, Kayla.
Where have you been, Mama? I looked all over for you, but you weren't here.
Dear Journal, I think I might be going insane. I've suffered several waking nightmares over the past few days, all of which felt overwhelmingly demonic in nature. Are nightmares supposed to feel this real? I pray that this is just some phase that I'm going through. Monsters don't exist, right? My husband isn't answering my calls or texts, and he's over 1,000 miles away. He has his own struggles with mental health, and it worries me so badly when he goes silent. My daughter seems sensitive to visions of her own that I don't understand, and it scares me. Please, God, help us. I know you're out there. It'll be good news if this is all just in my head. I just need it to go away for good.
My face. It was so strong.
Hey, kiddo. Oh, I missed you.
I missed you too. You okay, Mom?
Yes, I'm okay.
Everybody's okay.
I'll get to it. Thank you.
Hey, kiddo. Can't sleep? I thought I heard you here talking to yourself.
No, silly. I'm talking to Dad. See?
Hello, Angela.